I retired from my other job, I rode cross country from Virginia to Oregon by myself. It was during that trip that I said, you know, I should give others this opportunity to see and feel and taste and smell the country like you'd only do on a bicycle. So I thought about it for a couple years, and 2009 I decided to go ahead and put the trip together. And so 2010 I offered it for the first time to the public. So this is our seventh year doing this. We started San Diego and we go to St. Augustine, Florida. 52 days, 45 riding days, and 7 non-riding days.
I am not a bike rider. I just started riding bike in December, and it is now March. I'm not sure what the date is, but Bruce asked me if I wanted to go bike ride across the country. And I said, well, you know, it's on my bucket list, but maybe we should wait a year. And Bubba said that perhaps the ride would not go off next year. So we forced ourselves to train and get ready for this year.
I'm from Holland, and it's my first time that I make a bicycle tour in the States. And I'm from Europe, so we did a lot of bicycle tours in Europe and Asia, Africa, but never in the States.
I met a woman 17 years ago that was training for one, and I just kept remembering that. And then last April, I met a girl that had actually done it, and when I met her, I knew that I could do it.
One of the things I market this tour is that these riders ride their bike, and we do everything else for them. As a matter of fact, today we even did their laundry. So we accumulated laundry last night, dirty and stinky and wet, and we did the laundry here in Yuma and gave it back to them today, nice and clean and fresh and dry and folded. That's a huge benefit for these riders. We also have a chef. Has fantastic meals. Today was one of them, great meals. We have two bike mechanics. We have a massage therapist. We have guys that do all the legwork, carry the luggage. And so we do everything but ride your bike. And I think that's a real advantage for people to sign up for this tour. It's really one of the huge selling points.
I'm a yoga practitioner. I practice yoga. And my doc said I should probably do something a little more aerobic. So that's how cycling came in, but it more had to do with just something on the bucket list, riding across the United States. So I'm really not that much into cycling, I just wanted to ride across the United States.
I'm now 65, and when I was 5 years old, I had already a bike. My first big tour I did in 73, from Holland to Spain and back. That was nice.
This is my first tour. I've cycled since I was 14, but I've never done a tour.
Well, these people get together, they have reunions. It's not uncommon for me to get an email and say, hey, the 2015 group is getting together, we're doing this, we want you to come along. These people get extremely close, and it is a family. I tell them from day one, even before when they register, that this is, you will come back, this, you will become a family soon. And this group is becoming a family actually sooner than most groups are. So I'm really looking forward to this.
First day was okay, it was no bad weather, but it was really bad hills. But the second day, I think it was 39 degrees and it rained the whole time. We didn't actually make the full 30 miles. We only made 15 because we were almost hypothermic. It was so cold. So that was awful. And then the next day, it was almost as bad because we ran into the hail and the snow at the top of the mountain. But we held on and rode down the highway and got out of the rain and snow, and it was better. Today was excellent. Beautiful weather, flat roads, which is what I like, and not too many hills, and except for Yuma Road, which is really, really bumpy, the ride was excellent.
When you're on a bicycle, you can see a little yellow dot on the side of the road. As you bike closer, you can see it becoming a flower. You get a little closer, you can actually see the bee inside that flower. as you go by. On a car, doubtful you even notice that little yellow spot. If you would, it'd just be so fast. That's it. You get to see things you can never see on the side from a car. Plus, you get to meet people. You know, these people stop and talk to the locals. I encourage them. I said, if you see somebody sitting on the front porch swing, stop and talk to them. If you see it going to the cafe, stop and talk to the locals. Find out what it's like to live in this area. What do you do for a living? What did you do for a living? That's the important stuff. That's the important stuff. You get to see, hear, smell, taste all the way across the United States.
I just love the U.S. and I love rural America, and I wanted to see it, and I didn't want to see it